Chaos on the court in Harford County. Officials are now investigating a huge brawl at a high school basketball playoff game. It happened last night at Fallston High School. 11 News reporter George Lattice is live in Bel Air, where sheriff's deputies are investigating. George.
Well, Donna, that's right. We're told criminal charges could be filed in this case. The fight ended with a 48-year-old man on the Fallston side allegedly punching a 17-year-old kid on the Elkton High School side. It all began with 28 seconds left in the game. Fallston had a big lead. A foul was called, and two players started throwing punches.
The fight between players escalated to 8 to 10 separate fights involving people in the stands. The Harford County Sheriff's Office says 50 to 60 people ended up in the brawl on the court.
It was fisticuffs. It was people pushing, shoving, or taking swings at one another. It was an escalated situation in a crowd.
The punching, choking, and shoving was too much for the two sheriff's deputies working security for the game. At some point, authorities say, a 48-year-old man on the Fallston side punched a 17-year-old boy from Elkton. The boy got a bloody nose and lip. Fallston's head coach tells me over the phone it was the same boy who was choking him moments before. It's unclear if the man accused of punching the 17-year-old is a parent of a Fallston player. Either way, Harford County Schools have a message for parents or adults who come to school-sponsored sporting events.
We need the parents to model the behavior that, you know, we want our students to follow. And, you know, even though sometimes that may be difficult in the heat of the moment, we really need the backing of the parents as well to help us to keep these sporting events, which emotions can run really high, but we need to make sure that they stay professional as they should be.
Now we're told that the 17-year-old boy who was punched is not an Elkton basketball player. He could file civil charges against the man. The sheriff's office could file criminal charges as well. As for the game, because Fallston had such a big lead, the league gave Fallston the victory, and they will play tomorrow in the regional finals. But two of its players may not be able to play because they were injured in this brawl. We're told they either got some bruised ribs or some broken ribs. So a lot of questions to answer in this latest basket brawl. We're live in Harford County. George Lattice, WBAL-TV 11 News.